when you have 40% of small businesses unable to pay rent, you have a problem. Hey guys, it's November 2nd, 2022. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcat. 37% of small businesses reported that they couldn't really pay rent in October. 37% of small businesses, and about 49% of restaurants. So this ripple effect of inflation affecting people's pocketbooks and affecting their decisions to spend money in certain places like restaurants is having a ripple effect. People are spending less and less money in restaurants. That's gonna create even more ripple effects. There are gonna be some layoffs. Now, speaking of layoffs, Twitter, they're gonna have some layoffs pretty soon. They're gonna lay off about 3,700 employees. Now, as you know, Elon Musk, richest man in the world, pretty much took over. He bought Twitter and he fired some top people, the CEO and some top people at the very within that organization. He's advocating, well, he's reportedly advocating free speech. He wants to stop the censorship in Twitter. We'll see if that actually materializes. But the next phase, first he got rid of the people at the very top, and then after that, it looks like he's gonna get rid of a lot of people in the middle and at the bottom. And apparently he used a lot of people at Tesla and some of the top managers who were left at Twitter to sort of decide who they would keep, who contributed the most, and who was basically just dead weight. And if he's serious about transforming Twitter into an entity where people are going to have free speech, then he's not going to need the same amount of employees that Twitter previously needed, because they're not focused so much on censoring people and controlling the narrative and creating a narrative, then they don't really need that size of a workforce. I hate to see people lose their jobs, but that's just a certain reality that they're going to have to deal with. That's just it right there. All right, Russia. Well, Russia, they're moving hypersonic missiles to Belarus. There's some satellite imagery showing some MiG-31 fighters. Apparently, they're moving assets into Belarus that could potentially be used in a nuclear exchange. So Belarus looks like they're going to play an even bigger role in the situation with NATO and Russia. They may possibly go into Western Ukraine if NATO forces enter Western Ukraine. It could be a really bad situation. Speaking of World War III, or potential for World War III, Liz Truss, the former Prime Minister of the UK, the Russians are claiming, or some Russian sources are claiming, that she was caught sending a text message to Blinken, Anthony Blinken in the US government, sending him a message saying it's done, about a minute or so after the Nord Stream pipelines were attacked. Again, this is a claim. The US is saying that this is factually incorrect or whatever, it's factually ridiculous or whatever. Although it does raise the question, why was she only prime minister for 44 days? I mean, on one hand, you gotta wonder, how stupid is this lady to do something like that if she really did that? But then on the other hand, you gotta wonder, okay, why was she only prime minister for only 44 days? I mean, you gotta wonder, I mean, is there something to that? And even if the Russians can prove that, who's willing to listen, and what are the Russians going to do about that? Recently, the Russians stopped the grain deal they had with the UN. A lot of the grain in Ukraine was going out to Europe, whatever. But they restarted it. They got that going again. I don't know how long that's going to last, but they did get that going again. So Russia did decide to rejoin that. But yeah, what are the consequences? You can draw all these red lines all you want, but if Russia doesn't create consequences, nobody's going to respect them. NATO won't respect those red lines, and then NATO's going to be encouraged to cross more red lines. But I mean, that's if you're taking the Russian perspective. But anyway, right here in the U.S., we have our own problems. Inventory, diesel inventory. Now, there's been some articles released recently telling us, oh, well, don't worry about the diesel inventory situation. It's not as dire as you think. Well, here's a quote. This is from Ed Harris, professor of energy and economics, and at the University of Houston. Now, this guy said, quote, inventories of diesel and gasoline are down below the five-year average. And if the entire world were to stop, we would have 25 days worth of diesel. But the world doesn't stop. We're not counting on it stopping. Okay. So this is his way of trying to reassure people that, hey, Yeah, even though our diesel reserves are down and we rely on diesel to transport a lot of our goods all across the country, and our entire economy relies on that, even for heating in certain situations, you know, it's not that big of a deal. Well, isn't that calculated that supply on hand is down 15% compared to last year? It's down 31% compared to 2 years ago. And normally we would have about 35 to 40 days stock, but now we only have 25 days. We look at the fact that Biden's been taking a lot of our oil from the Strategic Petroleum Reserve. If there was a big crisis with China or war with China or Russia, hopefully that doesn't happen, we would be in a pretty awkward situation, really bad situation. Just a thought. And speaking of bad situations, the National Report Card, according to the National Assessment of Educational Progress, the National Report Card, over the last 2 years, fourth and eighth graders have suffered in math proficiency. And math is really important because that's going to determine what type of options you really have in college as far as becoming an engineer and really getting better paying jobs. If you can't do math, you're going to be pretty limited to fields that don't pay very well. And that's going to create more limits for you socially, and especially if you're a guy. Like if you're a woman, you can always find a guy who makes more, a higher status guy. But no matter who you are, if you're a woman, you want to be independent, truly independent, you're going to need some math skills. But anyway, just 26% of 8th graders were able to perform math competently. Just 26%. And over the last 2 years, 4th and 8th graders, their math proficiency suffered the largest decline ever recorded. The largest decline ever recorded. Now, this comes after The Atlantic printed the article called "Let's Declare a Pandemic Amnesty." Then they went on to say, "We need to forgive one another for what we did during the COVID pandemic." Really interesting. So after the narratives and all the lies and all the threats, you better get the you know what, or you're fired. Get this or you're fired. Or if you don't get this, then you're a bad person. All this rhetoric, all that talk. All the lies, people being taken off of an organ transplant list because they didn't get the what? And now you're saying, oh, we need amnesty? I mean, come on. I think we need to hold people accountable for their actions. I think we need to hold political leaders accountable for their actions because too many people went on a power trip. And one of those people was Whitmer, Michigan Governor Whitmer, okay, who is running for re-election. She's going up against Tudor Dixon, who I think is a really good candidate, but I still think Whitmer will probably prevail in Michigan. I haven't lived in Michigan in a long time. Maybe things have changed, but it is a blue state. And all this talk about, you know, Colorado being in play in the Senate, no, the Democrats are a solid blue state. Same thing with Washington. Tiffany Smiley seems like a pretty decent candidate, pretty good candidate actually, but you need more than that to overcome the fact that it's a solid blue state. I see her losing that. I don't think the Republicans are going to get a pickup there. New Hampshire, I still think the Democrats are going to hold there as well, although the polls have moved closer to the Republican side. I do think the Democrats, when it comes to the midterm elections, I think they're going to pick up Pennsylvania. Of course, is the Fetterman-Oz race. And of course, Fetterman had a complete disastrous meltdown on stage during his debate. Fetterman was terrible. You couldn't understand what the guy was saying. I don't think it's going to matter that much in the long run because about 240,000 unverified mail-in ballots went out in Pennsylvania. And if it's close, I think that's going to be a factor. Although recently, this Pennsylvania Supreme Court ruled that if a ballot was undated or dated beyond the election date, they had to set that aside, it wouldn't be counted. Now, is that actually going to happen? Well, there's warnings that, in Pennsylvania, there could be, it could take days for them to count the votes. My perception is, in Pennsylvania, they have their election day comes, they have their mail-in ballots and all this stuff, the election day comes, and once they look at all the ballots coming in from the red counties, they pretty much calculate how many ballots they need to produce in the following days. Okay, maybe I'm wrong. that's maybe I'm being too cynical because of what happened in 2020. Maybe I'm just wrong. Maybe you guys are telling me what you think. That's my perception. I think Fetterman will win in Pennsylvania. Obama and Biden's going to come down and try to help him out. Although I think Obama will help in campaigning for Fetterman. Biden, not so much. Well, maybe people look at Biden and say, oh, well, Fetterman's still more articulate, still in a better spot than Biden. But, you know, I understand Fetterman, he has a health issue, and I don't like to see people suffer. I want to see him recover from that. But based on his policies, especially in criminal justice, I don't think he's going to be a good fit for the people of Pennsylvania. But I could be wrong. They may disagree. Speaking of which, New York. There's a lot of talk about, Zeldin or whatever his name is, a Republican in New York. He's going to be he could become the next governor of New York. I don't think that's going to happen. No. Yeah. It's a situation where his opponent is completely incompetent, a Democrat, who was saying, oh, I don't understand why crime is such a big deal to you. She's completely out of touch. She only got the job because Cuomo had to resign. And frankly, people are fed up in New York. That's my perception. I don't know if they're that fed up. There was a situation, one of the issues is crime and the bail system. And New York's one of those few states where you can't use, a judge can't use, well, I think they're sort of limited in what they can use as far as the defender's background a lot of times in bail. That's my understanding of that. And there was a situation where this guy, he had a violent crime, he had a violent record, guy got out on bail. His wife was terrified of him. He killed her within 24 hours in front of her three kids, okay? She was so scared of this guy, she was walking around in a vest, in an actual vest, body armor, right? He shot her, I think, with a shotgun. So anyway, what do I think is gonna happen in the midterm elections? I think Adam Laxalt and Nevada is probably gonna win for the GOP. Nevada's been moving further and further to the right gradually. We saw that in 2020. Georgia, Walker, I think he's actually going to pull this off. The polls are definitely moving in Walker's direction, the Republicans' direction. I had some serious reservations about the guy. I thought he was going to lose in the beginnings. I thought he was just, wow. Let's just say I was impressed by his debate performance. He did a lot better than I thought he would do. I think he really helped himself. And there may be a runoff because in Georgia you have to have 50% to actually clinch the win. So they're going to have this election and the top two candidates are going to the runoff election. It's kind of annoying, I think. But anyway, so I think he's got a good chance. So the Republicans will pick up that seat, pick up Nevada. Arizona, I had my doubts about Masters winning there. It's still a close race with Kelly. But the fact that the Libertarian, who was getting, what, 6% of the vote, dropped out and then endorsed Masters in Arizona, that makes me think that, yeah, Masters has a real chance of winning. I think he'll pick that up. Vance, I think he'll win, the Republican in Ohio. Wisconsin, Johnson, I think he'll win. The polls are showing that Bud's going to probably win in North Carolina. Alaska, which really fascinates me. It's not just a matter of, okay, which party wins how many seats. It's the quality of candidates you're putting in place, because it doesn't matter how many seats you get if you get a bunch of people who are just establishment candidates, whether they're Republicans or Democrats. They want to support war, reckless war policies. That's not going to do us a lot of good. They want to infringe on the Bill of Rights. That's not going to do us a lot of good, regardless of their partisan politics, so to speak. Alaska, what do you guys think about that? Murkowski, whatever her name is, she's a mainstream Republican, and she's finally being challenged there, so it'll be interesting to see what happens there. So what do you think is going to happen with the midterm elections? I think Republicans are probably going to end up with 52 seats. They're going to lose the Pennsylvania seat. They're going to pick up seats in Arizona, Georgia, and Nevada. That's my perception. That's what I'm seeing. They have no chance of getting Colorado or Washington, although the polls in Washington are pretty close. The polls in New Hampshire are pretty close, and polls are usually pretty biased against Republicans, so maybe I'm wrong. If things go really, really bad, then we could have some, I think we can look at a, we're probably gonna see a major move when it comes to Harris. There's a poll saying that suburban white women now support Republicans by 15 percentage points. It's a movement of 27 points. 27 points over. Okay, what am I, Trump now with these hand gestures? pretty significant. If that's true, then 52 seats going to the Republicans may end up being more like 54. But I expect It can easily get really bad for the Democrats, okay? I'll tell you right now, because a lot of these races are really, really close. Like Pennsylvania could easily go to Oz. New Hampshire, Republican. Washington is still close. It's a blue state, but it's still close. I'm going to be paying a lot of attention to the gubernatorial races, the governor races, especially in Michigan, just to give me an idea of what's actually going on in that state. So, anyway, guys, these are some of the things that are on my mind. I did a video on Mylar bags, some rice. I wasn't satisfied with the way they turned out as far as the bags, but now it looks a lot better. I like to see them suck in, so it's not a lot of air in there. But I'm going to put some sugar in some Mylar bags. I'm not going to put any oxygen absorbers in the ones with sugar, because that just makes the sugar harder. But sugar, flour, stuff like that is really important. Really important thing to have in your emergency prep. So my plan is to put these bags, these containers, protect them from rodents or any type of bugs or critters or whatever. So that's what I'm doing. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for today.